Bill Apter. I appreciate all the support you've given us. Mr. Keller, Mr. Meltzer, all of you and all the members of the press, I want to thank you for all of your support so far. We're all thrilled to have you here at this press conference. Ladies and gentlemen, I guess I'll start now with our first major announcement here, and that is that on September 18th, we are pleased to announce that we will be having our first major show called Ultra Clash 1. Yes, this has been signed for September 18th at the ECW Arena. And let me just tell you a little bit about it. We've already signed for this match Stan the Lariat Hansen and Abdullah the Butcher. They will both be in Philadelphia on September 18th at Ultra Clash 1. In addition to that, we've already signed a Return Grudge Skywalker scaffold match. That's correct, a scaffold match pitting the Dark Patriot against Philadelphia's very own Jazzy J.T. Smith. In the upcoming weeks, the rest of the card will be announced. However, I will go on record right now in front of all of the media present and state that this show will be the greatest show in the history of Philadelphia wrestling. September 18th, Ultra Clash 1. Yes, Mr. Keller, I believe you have some questions you wanted to ask.
Oh, what is it?
Yes.
He won't listen to me. He's insisting on coming in.
Excuse me, please. All right, listen.
Hello, everybody. First off, I want to know, hey, why don't you go ahead and start driving Social Security somewhere? Listen, how come you didn't let me know about the board of directors meeting? Everyone knows that I'm part of this now. Actually, I probably own part of this company. Besides, I should know about these things. I have decisions that need to be made. And also, I want to know something, Mr. Gordon.
You're not going to talk about this company in front of the media. We'll let you ask me about
it. How come you already done too good of a job for that? Listen, who am I wrestling Ultra Clash anyway? I heard Stan Hansen's going to be here. Am I wrestling him? Am I wrestling Abdullah the Butcher? I heard Terry Fox's name mentioned. I heard Hawk. What do you got down
here? You will find out when you're wrestling this man.
Give me that.
That's enough.
Cut off.
Let's get this man out of here now.
I want to
let
the man. No, I should listen to me. I'm the king.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the ECW Control Center for an exciting week of Eastern Championship Wrestling. I have some major announcements for you this week, so batten down the hatches and get ready. This is the weekend coming up you don't want to miss. This is the weekend, August 7th and August 8th, Saturday and Sunday night, bell time, 7 p.m. You can be part of the ECW TV tapings. Come on down, watch the matches, and then sit home for the next couple of weeks and watch yourself on television. Scheduled to appear at this week's TV tapings are Stan the Lariat Hansen, the man who broke Bruno Sammartino's neck, my own personal nemesis, Hot Stuff, Eddie Gilbert, Paul E. Dangerously, former Intercontinental Champion Tito Santana, the heavyweight television champion of the ECW, Jimmy Superfly Snuka, the heavyweight champion of the ECW, Don the Magnificent Morocco. In tag team action, you'll see Ivan and Vladimir Koloff. Sensational Sherry makes her ECW debut this week. In addition to that, the Dark Patriot will be here, the Super Destroyers, Wildman Sal Balomo, the Sandman and Peaches, and a brand new group from Japan called Wing, possibly the most exciting federation in all of Japan, and you're going to see what I'm talking about a little bit later in the show, and we show you some of these phenomenal athletes and the type of matches they're capable of putting on. And they're coming here with a joint group federation here for a few weeks as the ECW. You got to tune in, folks, and you want to come down and see this live. Don't forget, if you want to come this weekend, you can get directions or information simply by calling the ECW hotline. That's 215 area code 544-0421. As I promised you fans last week, I'm going to be announcing some of the main events and some of the matches to be happening September the 18th, Ultra Clash 1. Before I mention those matches, I'd just like to personally apologize to John Kruk for that incident this past Wednesday night with Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert. And he knows what I'm talking about. Already signed for September 18th, the Ultra Clash, Stan the Lariat Hansen and Abdullah the Butcher, making his ECW debut. They'll be involved in a main event, which we'll be talking about in the weeks to come. Also, a Return Grudge Skywalker scaffold match, featuring Philadelphia's very own Jazzy J.T. Smith as he goes up against the Dark Patriot. And we'll show you also in today's show what precipitated this return grudge match. And this match just added the first ever Battle of the Sexes Battle Royal. That's right, Battle of the Sexes. And the participants for this match will include Peaches, Tigra, Angel, Hunter Q. Robbins III, Freddie Gilbert, and Sensational Sherry. Needless to say, fans, this is one you don't want to miss. It's never been done before. So sit back, wrestling fans, fasten your seatbelt for the fastest hour in all of television, ECW Wrestling. And after this break, we'll be right back with the match that precipitated this return grudge match between Jazzy J.T. Smith and the Dark Patriot. Stay tuned, son.
What is it?
Well, it's,
Carver W. Reed, corner of 10th and Sansom.
Here at ringside with Paulie Dangerously, fans, we've got a big matchup here between the Philadelphia native J.T. Smith and the mysterious Dark Patriot.
A man so mysterious, even Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert is not comfortable standing around him. You know, these two feuded over the North American Heavyweight Championship. And now, if just Hot Stuff the King Eddie Gilbert would trust my judgment, another fine addition to the organization here in the ECW, the Dark Patriot.
The Dark Patriot, former North American heavyweight champion, wrestling with J.T. Smith here.
And J.T. Smith, let's give him credit, he's a fine, fine athlete. The Dark Patriot not making his debut against any slouch, any pushover. He's going straight to the top against J.T. Smith, and wham, right in the chin.
Big right hand by the Dark Patriot. That one knocked J.T. senseless. Spun him right around in the ring, Paulie. Irish whip across the rope. Elbow by the Dark Patriot.
Obviously, the Dark Patriot. Now, you see, notice Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert a little worried. You have to be worried when a man like the Dark Patriot is in the ECW. You never know what to expect. This man has absolutely no mind. He has no regard for his own body. Whoa! Let alone anybody else's. Beautiful side slam by the Dark Patriot.
Knocking the wind out of J.T. Smith. There's the cover by the Dark Patriot. He got a two count, fans. That was close, Paulie. I thought we had a victory early in the match there with the Dark Patriot.
Hey, he's right. The man has figured it out. Jimmy Hoffa is the Dark Patriot. We might as well take off his mask. The man has figured it out.
Paulie Dangerously.
I congratulate you, sir.
Would you get serious? We've got an important match to call here, and you're joking around about Jimmy Hoffa. What's the Dark Patriot?
What does the sign say?
You know it's not Jimmy Hoffa.
Well, the man claims that it is.
Okay, Paulie.
Actually, my commentary was not actually myself joking. It was commentary on the foolishness of the fans here in Philadelphia to actually think that, oh, my.
Another side slam by the Dark Patriot, but J.T. rolled out of it and was able to reverse that maneuver.
Right into a scissors, and now here you see Smith now going for a slam. Had trouble scooping him up, but used his tremendous lower body strength. And now he's going up top.
Oh, a moonsault by J.T. Smith, one of his patented moves. There's the cover on the Dark Patriot. There's one, there's two. Dark Patriot able to kick out after two.
He was only able to kick out. I'll give J.T. Smith credit because Smith didn't hit the moonsault all the way. But you see, the Dark Patriot has no regard for his own body. So imagine how much regard he has for J.T. Smith.
Reverse Irish whip by J.T. The Dark Patriot in the corner. Oh, the Patriot out of the way. J.T. shoulder first into that steel ring post. Two fall out of the ring now. Dark Patriot knocking JT on his back outside on the concrete.
Now, this is not where Smith wants to be with the Dark Patriot. The Patriot is twice as dangerous outside the ring as he is inside the ring. And inside, he's one of the most dangerous of all.
Oh, but JT Smith, a nice reversal of that whip, whips the Dark Patriot into the steel ring post himself. He's got the Patriot reeling. Patriot back into the ring. Here comes JT following him in.
Well, now you see the Dark Patriot is playing it cool. He's backing off. He's trying to delay for time. He's trying to catch a second wind, but Smith coming right at him, throwing in the punches.
Firing away with those left hands, JT. Oh, reversal on the whip there by the Dark Patriot. Down goes the referee. Incredible action. What's going on here, Paul Lee?
What's going on is once again the Dark Patriot showing you just how dangerous he can be, taking JT Smith outside the ring and nailing him right in the face.
You're right, Paulie. This Dark Patriot seems more comfortable outside the ring than he does inside the ring.
And that was a classic maneuver. He walked him right into the ring post and rammed the top of his head. Now J.T. Smith has no idea where he's going, and quite frankly, neither do I.
We're going to have to keep an eye on the monitor. Oh, ramming J.T. Smith's head into the wall here of the ECW arena. These two are way out of the ring, folks.
I have no idea where they're going or why. Hey, they're coming up here.
Oh, my goodness. Oh, my goodness, these wrestlers are making their way up here to the Eagles' nest.
Well, keep them the hell away from me, because I don't want any part of it.
Paul, dangerously, what's going on here?
Well, what are you asking me for?
Here comes the Dark Patriot. He's right up here next to us at the TV booth. We're up here in the Eagles' nest. Here comes JT.
Hey, you can't do that.
Right here in front of us, folks, we've got...
That's a 20-foot drop.
At least a 20-foot drop. What's trying to call the action here, fans, but... J.T. Smith firing away with right hands right here in my announcing booth. Incredible.
Yours? How about mine? This is at least a 12. Whoa, this is dangerous. This is death-defying. Well, go ahead.
Dark Patriot's got Paulie Dangerous. Oh, my God.
Oh,
here goes J.T. Smith. J.T. Smith is falling over the edge.
See ya. Have a nice day.
I can't
see. All right. Hey, Patriot, that's enough. What are you doing? Patriot, what are you doing?
What's this guy
doing?
This guy's crazy. The Patriot's
on here. Patriot, get down here. No.
What's
you
he
can't
up?
Do that!
Paulie, he can't
you cannot do that! Don't do it!
Oh my God! The Patriot dove off our announcer's booth at least 20 foot down onto a prone J.T. Smith. The most incredible thing I've ever seen in my whole life, Paulie Dangerously.
Well, get him back in the ring. Oh my God, he's still walking. Get him back in the ring, and we have a victory.
J.T. Smith laying prone, laying unbelievable right here beneath our announcing booth. The Dark Patriot dove 20 foot on top of J.T. Smith. The most incredible thing I've ever seen in my life. The referee's back up, Paulie. He's counting. What's he counting for?
Nine, 10.
The Dark Patriot back
it's over.
In the ring.
It is over. The Dark Patriot has won the most unbelievable death-defying maneuver I have ever seen.
Don't forget, fans, the next ECW television taping extravaganza, August 7th and 8th at the ECW Arena. Starting time, 7 p.m. both nights. The bad man from Borger, Texas returns. The man who broke Bruno's neck, Stan the Lariat Hansen, is back. Formerly one half of the WCW World Tag Team Champions, Shane Douglas makes his ECW debut. Self-proclaimed King of Philadelphia, Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert returns from his tour of Philadelphia to defend his crown. Former WWF Intercontinental and Tag Team Champion, Tito Santana will be in action. Sensational Sherry makes her ECW debut. Paulie Dangerously, along with a whole Dangerous Alliance, including heavyweight champ, the Magnificent Morocco, TV champion Jimmy Superfly Snuka, and the mysterious Dark Patriot. Ivan and Vladimir Koloff return, and of course, the wild man Sal Bellomo will be there to greet all the kids. A two-night tournament to crown the new ECW Tag Team Champions, along with all the other top stars in the ECW. That's August 7th and 8th at the ECW Arena in South Philadelphia, 7 p.m. bell time. For more information, call the ECW hotline at 544-0421. The action's going to be hot August 7th and 8th.
reshape the body is a relatively simple procedure. You begin by removing the excess from one area and molding it into muscle in a more desirable position. This may be easily accomplished by use of a simple household apparatus, the Soliflex Fitness Machine, just $39 a month. What are you waiting for?
Daryl Dawkins used to name his backboard-shattering dunk. The NBA Jam Session book has it. When you say it...
Stop with thunder flying.
My, keep shaking.
Glass breaking.
I'm roasting.
One, two...
We're back, wrestling fans, and for those of you who are wondering what happened to our normal host, Jay Sully, he's vacationing this week in the south of France, out trying to find Norman Breaman, I suppose, to find out how he could let Jim McMahon get away. I'm not quite sure. But coming up is a very exciting match, where a week after the Dark Patriot J.T. Smith match, J.T. Smith, don't ask me why, decided to come out and wrestle again, where he teamed up with Glenn Osborne, and they went up against a very, very interesting team, the team of Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert and the Dark Patriot. A team that, much to Eddie Gilbert's dismay, Paulie Dangerously put together. And any of you wrestling fans who know the history between the Dark Patriot and Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert, this match is especially interesting. Let's keep our eye on both of them right now.
An hour and a half to watch 60 minutes. I just so happened to notice, sir, you come at Paulie and I were discussing over here, J.T. Smith coming down to ringside with his knee all bandaged up here and his wrist all bandaged up here. And if anybody watching ECW just happened to miss, a few shows ago, Mr. J.T. Smith came sailing off the top of the building over here, courtesy of my partner, Dark Patriot. Now, we all know that this is supposed to be... Shut up just a second, boy, all right? We know that this is supposed to be a tag team match. But it looks like, sir, that you're not able to wrestle, so why don't you just stand on the floor there with your little crutch. Glenn Osborne, you can have my friend, well, my partner, the Dark Patriot here, and I'll stand out here with Paul Lee since you're unable to wrestle, boy, and why don't you just get on the floor there and do what you do best, and that's nothing.
Let me tell you something. I'll have to back down for nobody. I don't need no crack. Okay. To take care of you, okay? Let's get in the ring and wrestle.
Oh, how about that, Don Morocco? Eddie Gilbert trying to get J.T. Smith to bow out of this match due to the leg injury he suffered just a few weeks ago here when he got knocked out of the Eagles' nest, and J.T. throwing the crutch away and getting ready for action here against Eddie Gilbert and the Don Patriot.
I'm a little disappointed in the hot stuff. Is that he even offered him to get out? He should have. I see two of the finest wrestlers in ECW, much less the world, in here, and I see two of the stupidest guys I've ever seen. First of all, you don't get into the ring if you're half a man with Hot Stuff International. Second of all, this guy got to be crazy to have this guy as a partner.
Unbelievable, fan. J.T. Smith, he's an incredible competitor here. Again, just a few weeks ago, 25 feet he fell out of the Eagles' nest to the hard concrete floor, and he's still able to wrestle this week.
Well, he walked in tonight on crutches. He'll probably go home in a wheelchair.
Well, he's definitely got one bad wheel, but... Oh, still able with a nice arm drag to take down Eddie Gilbert. Paulie dangerously outside the ring now, offering some words of advice to Eddie Gilbert. What might Paulie be saying to Eddie there, Don?
I think Eddie's just a little shocked that this guy's in the ring and wasn't gracious enough to take his offer and get out of here.
Paulie dangerously visibly upset ringside. Taking a lot of heat from the fans here.
I think they're worried about lawsuits and repercussions and such a nature. This guy is going to be a cripple by the end of the night.
I don't think they should worry about lawsuits. I think they should be worrying about the in-ring actions of J.T. Smith and Glenn Osborne. A nice roll-up by J.T. Smith on Eddie Gilbert.
He had his tights. Did you see him holding his tights there?
I didn't see a tight pull, Don Morocco. Paulie Dangerously asking for a timeout. You know, Don, there's no timeout in professional wrestling.
Psychological ploy, sir.
Okay. J.T. Smith still staying in the ring. Might be looking to tag in Glenn Osborne.
Oh, I think Al Gore just getting a call for Hot Stuff here.
Eddie Gilbert's got that telephone
must
of Paulie Dangerously.
Must be an environmental message he wants to send.
Yeah, that's it. Paulie's got no business with that phone at ringside for that very reason.
Hey, that phone serves a lot of purposes. He orders cabs, he makes plane reservations, pizzas, he can do all kinds of stuff.
Oh, J.T. Smith out of the way. Eddie Gilbert with a big knee to the midsection of the Dark Patriot. Ha! J.T. Smith a little quicker than Eddie Gilbert gave him credit for, I think.
You better get quick and start moving.
Oh, we got a little trouble possibly here brewing between the Dark Patriot
there
and Eddie Gilbert.
No trouble at all. Hot Stuff International. Dangerous Alliance never has any problems.
Paulie Dangerously up on ringside trying to keep these two competitors separated here. I don't know, Don.
It's just a tactical discussion.
A little team dissension possibly.
No dissension, discussion.
These two trying to work things out here ringside. J.T. Smith waiting to get back into action here with Eddie Gilbert. I believe Eddie's the legal man in the ring here. I could be wrong. Nope, I'm right. Eddie Gilbert, J.T. Smith, the legal man in the ring. Looks like Paul Lee's got things calmed down.
The Dark Patriot and Eddie Gilbert have had their problems in the past, but those soon have been rectified. And now it is a well-oiled, well-moving, unison, great machine. Hot Stuff Incorporated.
That's a close call there, Don Morocco. I don't know. I thought those two might come to blows, but...
Close call. Take the gloves off your glasses. Only close call they're going to see is whether they amputate or whether they put pins in the knee.
Test of strength by J.T. Smith there. And what's Eddie Gilbert do? He kicks the bad knee of J.T. Smith. Eddie Gilbert strutting around the ring. He's proud of himself.
Yeah!
Again, a kick to that bad leg. Unbelievable, Don Morocco. There's no excuse for those tactics.
No excuse. This is professional wrestling. This is the most violent sport in the world. This is man eat man, dog eat dog. And if you're fool enough, wrap it around that
foot. The Dark Patriot wrapping that bad knee of J.T. Smith. Not once, but twice around that metal ring steel. But unbelievable.
Look, Hot Stuff International is so concerned. Such a great group. Paulie Dangerously, at no charge to J.T. Smith, is calling the ambulance and ordering the wheelchair immediately after the match.
The Dark Patriot continuing to work over that bad leg of J.T. Smith. You're right, Don Morocco. We may need an ambulance after this display.
I'm always right, sir.
Oh, again he smashes that bad knee into that steel ring post. And a fourth time. I don't think J.T.'s going to be able to take. Oh, I can't even watch this, Don Morocco. A fifth time.
I can watch it. I can dig it.
And now a clubbing right hand to the back of J.T. Smith. J.T.'s out of the ring. Incredible, fans. What a disgusting display by the Dark Patriot. He's not even the legal man in the ring. What's going on here?
He's helping J.T. back in the ring where he wants to be. This boy wanted to be a wrestler.
Oh, Paulie dangerously knocking the timekeeper out of his chair and actually giving the chair to Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert. The referee's got his back turned. What's Eddie Gilbert going to do? He's not going to hit that leg with a chair. No, oh, he does stop Morocco. Eddie Gilbert just clubbing J.T. Smith to that metal chair from that bad leg. That's got to be
gonna
it.
Do? What's he going to do? What do you do when you have a horse with a broken leg?
Oh, shoot it. Don Morocco. J.T. Smith is in such brutal condition right now. Eddie Gilbert, what a despicable act. I've never seen anything like this. J.T. Smith, I guess, was mistaken to a figure four leg lock. And oh, he's got it stitched
wait,
in.
I got to take my headphones off. I got to listen to the leg breaking. I can't wait to hear the leg break.
Unbelievable, fans. This has got to be it. Eddie Gilbert's got the figure four leg lock on J.T. Smith, and he's got that bad wheel. There it is. The referee calls for the bell. I can't believe J.T. held on as long as he did.
He can't talk. He's ready to pass out.
Incredible. Things are breaking down. The Dark Patriot in the ring now with Glenn Osborne. Oh, and a boot to the head of J.T. Smith. We got to get out of here, fans. It's incredible.
His head didn't hurt there.
Stay tuned, fans. We'll be right back, hopefully with a report on J.T. Smith.
What report?
Superstars of Eastern Championship Wrestling can be seen every Tuesday night at 6 p.m. right here on Sports Channel. Eastern Championship Wrestling, it's not for everyone.
That was a very exciting match. J.T. Smith, boy, I'll tell you, took a lot of guts to get out there on that bad leg like that. And Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert and the Dark Patriot together. That's a team to keep your eye on. Who knows what's going to happen there.
Hello. Sorry, I didn't say hell, Matt. Matt, how are you? You miss me? Hey, he's back again.
To
hot, Mike.
No. Jay Sully. Jay Sully.
What are you doing, buddy? Huh?
Jay Sully's on
hey,
the...
Hey, when you get that light back there a little bit, it's kind of shining his head and blinding me. So what are we going to talk about? Paul McCartney and Wings here, right?
We're trying to talk about the...
We got a concert tape?
That won't let me talk.
We got a concert tape?
We're trying to talk about the Federation Wing from Japan. Are you familiar with this federation, Eddie Gilbert?
Yes, I am.
Well, do you want to tell the fans at home something intelligent?
Yeah. Eddie Gilbert.
Fans, let's take a look at the videotape.
Thank you. No! しい地獄巡りへ向けて走り出した。今度はどんな修羅場が彼らを待っているのだろうか。
皆さん、皆さん、これからも準備していきますので、本番は大変ですけども、みんなで選手も皆さんも一緒に声援を送りましょう。よろしいですか。
Jimmy Snuka, and you can tell it's not going to take much of an effect up on him, because if you let Snuka out of that ring for about 10, 15 minutes, believe me, he's as fresh as he ever is, because Snuka's in great condition. Cairo is also in great condition. That'll be real interesting. I've got a lot of respect for the discipline of Jimmy Snuka, if that makes any sense. He's a very disciplined athlete, and that's why that doesn't bother me. He's also a very tough individual, and we're fixing to see how he handles this
right now. The influence of Paul Lee dangerously on Jimmy Snuka, that's what scares me, Terry. Admittedly, Jimmy Snuka,
Jimmy Snuka's crazy as Mark Harris, too. I might add that, too. I'm just talking about his physical condition there, and I'm not talking about his mental condition.
Both these guys in great cardiovascular shape. Trying to get a tie up here. Tommy Cairo, Jimmy Snuka looking for a clean break, and he got it, but he's complaining to the referee about a hair pull. I didn't see that from Tommy Cairo.
I certainly didn't see a hair pull there. You know, I'll tell you what, this is going to be a heck of a battle between myself and Gilbert. You've got to remember what the rules are for that match. It's a Texas chain match, and what you have to do, you have to pull a man around to four consecutive corners in succession.
I don't know how you guys are going to do it. Chained together at the wrist, a battle the likes of Philadelphia has never seen. That's tonight's big main event between Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert and Terry Funk. I know I can't wait for it, Terry. I can't imagine how you're able even to work out here with me now. I would think you'd be in the back getting ready for your big match, but hey.
Well, I'll tell you what, I'll be back there before time, and we've got an intermission. I've got myself a good half hour of sitting down and thinking about it. A nice slam by Cairo.
Oh,
a beautiful kick.
Martial arts kick there, Terry. Incredible. Jimmy Snuka outside the ring. Paul Lee visibly upset here. He's just some words of wisdom for Jimmy Snuka here.
Taking those cobwebs out right now. Paulie trying to tell him something. I don't know how smart or how intelligent it is. I certainly wouldn't listen to him. I guess maybe they're trying to call a CG Island on that phone or something.
Paulie dangerously. I don't know why they allow him to bring that telephone ringside at all. How many times have we seen him use that phone?
Too many times, and I'll tell you, I'm not going to let him try to use that phone on me. I'll guarantee you that. I'll have somebody watching.
I hope you've got a set of eyes in the back of your head, Terry Funk. You're going to need them. It's tonight's big main event, I'll tell you. Look, they're back in the ring now. These two circling around each other, getting ready to tie up again. Pennsylvania State champ Tommy Cairo hasn't backed down at all here from the Superfly. Jimmy
Snuka pushing him into the ropes right now. Catches him with one knee right there. Watch Snuka here. He'll try to take advantage of him off that rope with that chop. There it is right there.
So much for that clean break. We saw one clean break earlier in the match with J.C. Smith, but that's about it. Oh, Tommy Cairo trying for the sunset flip, but Jimmy Snuka sits down on
Mike Cairo. Yes.
Now Cairo reverses. He's got a quick two count there, but Jimmy Snuka able to power out. I don't think Snuka's going to give that title up that easily, Terry Paul.
There was an illegal thumb to the rope. You notice that to the throat. You notice that Snuka moves around there quickly. He gets away from that referee. Here it comes again. Watch him. He'll turn him right away from that referee so that referee can't tell it. The referee should be moving.
Unbelievable. A thumb to the windpipe that's got it. Just cut the wind off of Tommy Cairo. Look at him gasping for air laying on the mat there.
Paulie dangerously is motioning that it was perfectly legal. I rather doubt that. Oh, big shot.
Oh, Jimmy Snuka, that a second. Knocking Tommy Cairo off his feet there. Moments ago, Slick is complaining about a hair pull, but he looks like he's trying to pull Cairo off by that short hair, but to no avail. Irish whip across the rope, just on a clothesline. Oh, a drop kick by Tommy Cairo. Incredible, Terry Funk.
That was a beautiful drop kick on his part. Cairo is right back on top of him with the vertical suplex.
Wow, Tommy
he's got
Cairo.
Snooker going right now. He needs to stay on top of him, try to get that pinfall in. Looks like he's going to try to do it, too. Let's see what he's going to try right here. Shoots him off into the rope. Coming off. Huge backdrop. Now Cairo should be on top of him. He should be trying for that pin right now.
Tommy Cairo should be looking for that cover. I agree with you.
You've got to take advantage of the opportune time, and that was it. Whenever Snooker went over, be on top of him. Try to get that streak down in there.
Paul Lee dangerously frantic ringside here. He sees Snooker on the ropes, and I think he sees his title slipping away here. Irish whips the Superfly into the corner, followed up by a nice flying elbow. Jimmy stuck a face first into the mat. Paul Lee dangerously, visibly upset outside the ring. Tommy Cairo bringing the Superfly up to his feet again. Getting him ready for a slam. Nice body slam. Jimmy Snooker rolls outside the ring.
Very smart move on Snooker's part. See, that's why if Cairo would have gotten him into a position in the ring where he could have stayed on top of him, held him within that ring, because he has a vantage point at this particular time.
Absolutely.
Another vertical suplex from the inside, outside in.
Look in the hard way from outside the ring with a nice suplex.
There it goes for the cover. There it is. Where's the two count over?
Jimmy Snooker able to kick out Vince at the count of two, but I believe that's the third or fourth two count we've seen, Terry. Snooker whips Cairo across the ring. Nice step over. There it is. Paulie dangerously outside the ring, tripping up the Pennsylvania State Champion.
I saw that. That was Paulie Dangerous.
Snooker's got his feet on the ropes.
Snooker had his feet on top of the ropes.
Unbelievable. Jimmy Snooker, Paulie dangerously from outside the ring, tripping up Tommy Cairo. That's Jimmy Snooker's second successful title defense of that TV title tonight, Terry, but I don't like the way that, you know, that happened there. Paulie dangerously tripping Tommy Cairo up. Jimmy Snooker using the ropes for leverage to get the pin. How can they feel good about a victory like that?
Don't forget, fans, the next ECW television taping extravaganza, August 7th and 8th at the ECW Arena. Starting time, 7 p.m. both nights. The bad man from Borger, Texas returns. The man who broke Bruno's neck, Stan the Lariat Hansen, is back. Formerly one half of the WCW World Tag Team Champions, Shane Douglas makes his ECW debut. Self-proclaimed King of Philadelphia, Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert returns from his tour of Philadelphia to defend his crown. Former WWF Intercontinental and Tag Team Champion Tito Santana will be in action. Sensational Sherry makes her ECW debut. Paulie Dangerously, along with a whole Dangerous Alliance, including heavyweight champ The Magnificent Morocco, TV champion Jimmy Superfly Snooker, and the mysterious Dark Patriot. Ivan and Vladimir Koloff return, and of course, the wild man Sal Balomo will be there to greet all the kids. A two-night tournament to crown the new ECW Tag Team Champions, along with all the other top stars in the ECW. That's August 7th and 8th at the ECW Arena in South Philadelphia, 7 p.m. bell time. For more information, call the ECW hotline at 544-0421. The action's going to be hot August 7th and 8th.
Now, there's an easy way to buy a Ford Thunderbird LX. It's as easy as 1, 2, 3.
The self-proclaimed King of Philadelphia is sitting to my left over here.
Is it true what I heard?
What did you hear?
Well, I heard at your household you kind of take my crown during the week and you walk around your house with my crown on.
Ultra Clash 1, ladies and gentlemen, September 18th. Mr. Gilbert doesn't know who his opponent is. But
and neither do you.
But he has signed an open contract, and we're going to find out in the upcoming weeks just who you're going to be facing at all.
I don't care who I face. You can bring the biggest name in professional wrestling, which is me right now. Bring them into Philadelphia, have them against me. Not only will we sell out the Spectrum, the ECW Arena, or anywhere around here, Veterans Stadium, we'll sell that out. I will also beat whoever you bring in here against me.
Well, just like I did, Will Sammartino.
Mr.
Yeah.
Gilbert, we're going to announce your opponent this weekend at the TV taping at the ECW Arena.
Come on down! You're the next contestant at the ECW taping this weekend. That's right, the 7 or 8 to 7 o'clock, right?
7 and 8 to 7 o'clock. We'll
Boy,
be there.
Home today, huh?
Stan Hansen's going to be there.
Yeah.
You're going to be there.
Yeah.
Paulie Dangers is going to be there.
That's right.
Tito Santana's going to be there.
That's right.
The Dark Patriot's going to be there.
And a woman I haven't had in wrestling yet, Sherry Martel, will be there.
There's a woman you... Oh, that's... Oh, sensational star. Okay, Sherry Martel will be there. That's correct. You'll also be in the ECW Arena.
Yeah.
And we will announce the whole card for Ultra Class 1 this weekend at the ECW TV tapings. The man sleeps with the crown. Ladies and gentlemen, Ultra Class 1 is coming up September 18th. It's going to be the biggest, hottest show in the history of Philadelphia wrestling.
That's right.
Even though he's going to still be on the show.
That's right. And I also want to ask you one other favor.
One question.
Can we please fire Jay Sully? Now, you got rid of Stevie Wonderful. Can we get rid of Jay Sully?
Jay Sully.
Or is he the ECW?
Fans, we'll see you next week.
Also.
I don't want to say anything on the air, but I really don't appreciate when you come busting in like that in the middle of the show and just take over like it's your show.
Well, Todd, it's kind of like this.
Eddie's World! Eddie's World!
Party on, Todd.